Good morning, everybody. Welcome to day four. I don't even know what day it is. Day four of, I think, just being here at home and doing in-home workouts. Actually, day one for me, participating with Chelle. She's been killing it. I'm gonna kill it today, so.
All right, let's get this started. I thought I caught your eyes, the love is blind. I thought I saw you smile. Workout with a pup. Do you know he weighs like nothing? Hi, baby.
Chelle, keep going! Do the Russian twist!
I thought I saw a light when you passed me by. Well, guys,
in-home workouts are not too bad. Chelle likes them more or less. That was my first one doing with her. I liked it, but you know who really liked it? Louie thought it was just fun and games, playing the entire time, grabbing his ball, jumping on us, licking Shelly. So probably made it not maybe the most effective workout that we have ever done.
He's so funny.
He is funny.
Hey, he's adding a little extra challenge, you know, when you're down there and he sits on your legs that you're trying to hold up.
A little added weight?
Yeah, a little added weight there.
I'll admit, he made it more fun for me.
Luckily, he doesn't weigh too much.
Yeah,
guys, we are definitely no workout professionals. It's something that we enjoy doing. But we are no professionals, so if our form's wrong, don't say anything.
Oh my gosh.
Just kidding.
We wanted to share that with you, just kind of what we're doing here in the house. Tons of good workouts with just, if you have one set of dumbbells, you can literally do so many different workouts.
Even if you just have like bands, and you don't even need dumbbells. Like I've been seeing people use like big jugs of soap or laundry detergent or something that they're using, just any like added weight to do really anything.
And just get moving, yeah.
Oh buddy, are you all done working out? Is it nap time?
He's exhausted.
Yeah. That was a rough workout for you, huh?
Sweet
little boy. Guys, that was fun. Little taste of home workouts from the Madsen home right now. It's safe to say we miss our gym, but it's kind of fun working out from home. We play our music really loud.
Yeah, she'll blast it on our little sound bar on the TV from her phone. It's awesome.
And then I've got my little workout program on my phone. I am using the Sweat app. I'm sure a lot of women out there have heard of it. It's 5 different trainers and they just have tons of workouts. And during all of this, it's actually kind of cool because they added a bunch of like at-home workouts. All 5 trainers added.
New at-home programs.
I haven't switched over to the at-home programs. I'm still doing the gym program right now just through the rest of this week, finding alternatives.
You don't have the
machine. Yeah, if I don't have like a machine or something, I'll do an alternative. But it's been really good.
All right, guys. Well, I got to get to work. My commute is about 25 seconds upstairs, so I should probably get that started. Oh, bye. You gonna join me?
Yeah, now Louie's gonna go bug Dad upstairs, huh?
You're the bug. I love it.
He's gonna go sit on his yap. Yeah.
No, only one of you bugs.
Hey! It's me. I bug.
Love you. All right, guys. We have cleaned up. The living room is back to normal. It's no longer an at-home gym. But we are kind of in need of a few necessities and a few food items. So we're actually going to go out, brave the stores really quick to see if we can find what we're looking for. It's most likely that we won't find what we need. But we're going to give it a try anyways. All right, guys, we just got out here to Costco, and I just want to say real quick, thank you to Chelle for loading up the car while I talk on the camera.
I got it, babe.
Guys, I was honestly extremely shocked at how pleasant that was. I have not been braving the grocery stores or Costco like a lot of other people have. Chelle, thankfully, has kind of been doing that while I have been working. But I came out with her today and I was honestly shocked at how pleasant it was. There's more parking in this parking lot than usual. It seemed like the shelves were extremely stocked, tons of stuff. We got the essentials we needed for some meals that we're planning on making next week. Still no toilet paper and that kind of stuff, which is interesting, but not too bad. That was kind of awesome. There's a little line out front. They're like letting people in waves or shifts just to regulate how many people are in the store at once. And they actually give you a cart when you walk in that has been like pre-sanitized, wiped down, which is really great and awesome. They're wiping down handles in the store, all of that. And they even have like X's at the checkout where each person is supposed to stay at their next X. So the X is about 6 feet away from the X in front of you, just to kind of keep people spread out. You know, they're definitely doing their part here at Costco. That was pretty awesome, guys. I'm kind of shocked and very relieved to see that that was like honestly a great experience. So we made it back in one piece. Costco was awesome.
First of all, huge shout out to all of our grocery store workers too. We did a really big thank you to all of our like medical professionals, but we need to say thank you to all of the people who are keeping our grocery stores open and running right now, because you guys are true heroes, honestly. Sorry, he was whimpering. I saw something funny on Instagram the other day. Not funny, kind of ironically cool, actually. But it said something to the effect of, you know, last week or 2 weeks ago, we worshipped professional athletes, celebrities, like all sorts of famous people. And in just a week's time, we owe everything to all of our medical professionals and people who are keeping grocery stores up and running and working hard. And it's just crazy how things have changed.
Yeah, our perspective has kind of been changed to like what's really important.
And, you know, little things like just the grocery store clerk or the bagger that we take for granted. It's like, thank you. We owe a lot to you, so thank you.
Yeah, a lot of you have even commented on our videos that you do work at grocery stores. Your family does work in the medical profession, and that's really awesome. Thanks for letting us know. We love hearing that kind of stuff. Thank you for all your hard work and for your family's dedication.
To go along with everything that already is going crazy and going on, we actually just received some crazy news that is honestly just such a bittersweet... Louie, honey.
Not right now, pal.
Honey, not right now. Part of the reason we actually went to Costco today to stock up on some essentials is because we just received some really bittersweet news. A lot of you have actually been asking about my parents and how they're doing and things like that, and we really appreciate everybody who has taken an interest in them. And we actually just found out today that they are on their way home. Our church has decided to send home all of its senior missionaries at this time to their home countries, and that includes my parents. So, unfortunately, my parents have been sent home from Ukraine. They're taking a crazy long journey. It's literally going to take them a couple days to get home. So it's kind of crazy. So today we went to Costco to stock up on some things to make sure that we had enough food and everything to feed for now for the next couple weeks. They're coming home. They're staying with us in our house because as you guys know, it's literally just me and Daniel and cute little Lou. And so we've got plenty of space to house them. And our whole upstairs, as you guys have seen, is kind of like its own little space up there. So they're going to be quarantining themselves for the next 2 weeks upstairs in our home, and it's kind of crazy. I'm excited to have like my mom back, and I'm excited to have them, but at the same time, it's so sad. They're so not ready to come home. They'd only been out for 6 months, and they did not want to come home, like at all.
So guys, definitely stay tuned. We're taking the rest of the day to kind of get the house ready. We're moving some stuff around, getting their space ready. Chelle has been cleaning like a mad woman.
I've been doing a lot of deep cleaning. It's actually felt really good because our house obviously needed it. So it's been really nice to get a lot of like the deep cleaning done that needed to be done, so that they can just kind of keep to themselves upstairs for the next 2 weeks.
Yeah, and be comfortable. That's what we really want, is them to be comfortable and happy and have, you know, this be a good experience, you know, at the end of the day.
Because they're sad to come home, so we're trying to make it somewhat not sad.
Yeah. Well, you're killing it. We'll show you guys what we have in store. A few surprises for them, but we're actually going to be most likely picking them up from the airport tomorrow night at 1 or 2 a.m. Their plane gets in really, really late. But stay tuned, guys. It's been a very interesting week.
Who's out there?
Lou's gonna be stoked too. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. We'll see you all later.